Hello students, today we are going to continue our second chapter, sexual reproduction in flowering plant. In my previous video, we have discussed about gamete transfer in flowering plant, that means the process of pollination. The transfer of pollen gene from the anther to the stigma of a flower and type of pollination, autogamy, zitanogamy and xenogamy. Autogamy is self-pollination. And student, continuous self-pollination lead to the chance of inbreeding depression. अगर continuously self-pollination होगा, so plant क्या show करेगा? Inbreeding depression. And what is this inbreeding depression? Actually, plant reduce biological fitness in a given population. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर continuous self-pollination होगा, so variation, plant didn't show any variation. और environment में survive करने के लिए variation should be necessary. Is that clear? So continuously self-pollination lead to chance of inbreeding depression. So what happened? Flowering plants have developed many devices to discourage self-pollination and to encourage cross-pollination. And these devices is called outbreeding devices. And today I am talking about four outbreeding devices which developed by plant. Okay, the first one is stigma and pollen release is not synchronized. That means either the pollen is released before the stigma become receptive or stigma become receptive before the release of pollen. That means stigma or pollen gain dono saath mein developed nahi honge, saath mein mature nahi honge. Ya to pehle pollen gain developed ho jayega, okay, or second condition, ya fir stigma firstly aapka receptive banega ya mature hoga. Dono ka saath mein developed hona nahi ho. Is that clear? So it lead to cross pollination in a bisexual flower because both are not able to mature simultaneously. Okay, so the first outbreeding device which developed by the plant is stigma and pollen release is not synchronized. Stigma और pollen gain दोनों साथ में mature नहीं होते हैं. या तो plant में पहले pollen released हो जाता है या फिर stigma पहले developed हो जाता है. Okay, the second condition is what? The anther or stigma are placed at different position. Anther और stigma दोनों ही different position पे होंगे और ऐसी position पे होंगे कि वो self pollination को avoid करेंगे या self pollination उनमें नहीं हो पाएगा. In a sometime it's happen student, in a bisexual flower उसमें स्टिग्मा और पॉलन दोनों इस तरीके से इस पोजीशन पे होते हैं कि वो उनमें सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन नहीं हो पाता. ओके, सो दैट द पॉलन कैन नॉट कम इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द स्टिग्मा ऑफ अ सेम फ्लावर. सो फर्स्ट डिवाइस इज स्टिग्मा एंड पॉलन रिलीज इज नॉट सिंक्रोनाइज, दोनों साथ में मैच्योर नहीं होते. सेकेंड, दोनों की पोजिशन इस तरीके की होती है कि वो सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन को अवॉइड करता है. And the third and very important, self incompatibility, because self incompatibility is referring to ability of a plant to reject its own pollen and the pollen of closely related individual. Actually student, the pistil, that means stigma, have an ability to recognize and accept the right pollen. Okay, so sometime what happened, the stigma reject the pollen gain and this condition is called self incompatibility. Okay, here you see that self incompatibility is referring to ability of a plant to reject its own pollen. Kabhi kabhi aisa hota hai ki stigma apne same flower ke pollen ko reject kar deta hai and this condition is called, this phenomena is called self incompatibility. Okay, this one is a genetic phenomena also. The fourth one and the last is The device to avoid self-pollination is to produce unisexual flower. Obviously, अगर unisexual flower है किसी plant में तो बहुत कम chances होंगे self-pollination के, क्योंकि flower क्या है, unisexual है, either it is male or female. So it lead to the chance of xenogamy, that means cross-pollination. So what are these four devices? The first one is stigma and pollen released are not synchronized. Second, their position. And third, self-incompatibility. And the fourth one is unisexual flower, to produce unisexual flower. I hope you understand. The next topic is pollen-pistil interaction. Actually, student, for fertilization, it's compulsory that pollen gain come in a context of a stigma, but the pistil have the ability to recognize and accept the right pollen of the same species and reject the pollen gain that are incompatible either of the same species or the other species. Pistil के पास ये ability होती है कि वो recognize कर सकता है सही pollen gain को, और ये ability क्या है, compatible, okay? और अगर उसने reject कर दिया pollen gain को तो that means incompatibility, okay? Here you see that through compatible pollination the pollen gain germinate on the stigma, because pistil have a ability to recognize the correct pollen gain. ओके, पिस्टल ने क्या किया, करेक्ट पोलन गेन को रिकॉग्नाइज किया और एक्सेप्ट किया. ओनली आफ्टर दैट, केवल इसके बाद ही पोलन गेन आपका जर्मिनेट होगा, ओके, एंड पोलन ट्यूब को फॉर्म करेगा, ओके, थ्रू द जर्म पोर. एंड द कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ अ पोलन गेन मूव थ्रू द पोलन ट्यूब टू रीच द ओव्यूल इन द ओवरी एट द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड. इज दैट क्लियर? हियर स्टूडेंट, what is the meaning of compatible and incompatible? Right type of a pollen land on the stigma, okay, and stigma accept that pollen, so this is called compatible. And if wrong type of a pollen land on the stigma, stigma reject that pollen, so it is called incompatible. Is that clear? And in this phenomena what happened, actually chemical compounds of the pollen interacting with those of the pistil, because of these chemical, because the stigma have the chemicals and pollen also, so because of this chemical compositions the pollen pistil interaction take place, okay. And after recognition of a correct pollen, pistil promote post fertilization events that lead to fertilization, okay. The next one is artificial hybridization. You know that it is a man-made method, and it's very important also. Sometimes the question is define emasculation, what is bagging, okay. These are the method of artificial hybridization. Artificial hybridizations has been used by the plant breeders for crop improvement, okay. The first is emasculation, and what happened in emasculation, the anther is removed from the bud before it dehisced using a pair of a forceps. Humne forceps ki help se, in this picture you see that in a bisexual flower, ek bisexual flower mein humne kya kiya, anther ko removed kar diya. Emasculation, always remember student that we removed anther, okay. And now the plant have only the female parts, that means stigma, ovary style, that means only gynoecium part is there, okay. So what is emasculation? When we remove the anther with the help of the forceps and the plant have only female parts. In this bisexual flower have only the female part, okay. The second one is bagging. What is bagging? The emasculated flower is covered by a bag of suitable size generally made up of butter paper. So as not to allow contaminated of stigma by unwanted pollen grain. अगर हमने फीमेल पार्ट को कवर कर दिया है तो अब उसमें अनवांटेड पॉलन गेन जर्मिनेट नहीं हो पाएंगे. एंड व्हेन द स्टिग्मा ऑफ बैग्ड फ्लावर बिकम रिसेप्टिव, जब हमारा स्टिग्मा डेवलप्ड होगा, जब हमारा फीमेल पार्ट डेवलप्ड होगा, देन द कलेक्टेड पॉलन गेन आर डस्टेड ऑन टू द स्टिग्मा एंड द फ्लावर इज रीबैग्ड एंड द फ्रूट अलाउड टू डेवलप्ड. ओके, दीज आर द टू मेथड. First is emasculation, in which we removed the anther part. Okay, and in bagging we covered the female part and only allow the pollen grain which we wanted, which are good for the plant. Okay, this is all for today. Thank you.